But they came back very convincingly, Australia, to win 22-10, Australia versus New Zealand in the final of the men's fours.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the 2016 World Bowls Championships, where it's time for your second final on this Saturday, the men's fours. Would you please help me in introducing and welcoming Australia, Barry Lester, Brett Wilkie, Aaron Wilson, and Mark Casey. And representing New Zealand, give a big warm welcome all the home fans here to Mike Nagy, Mike Kernahan, Blake Signal, and Ali Forsyth.
So that's all the official job done now. The players have been introduced, and a very responsive crowd too. And we'll look in the background there, a number of people, particularly family and friends from the New Zealand and Australian contingents here for this match today. This is the final of the men's four. And New Zealand won this in 1966 and 2008 here at Burnside. That was a wonderful world championship for the New Zealand teams. And Australia are the defending champions. They won this in 2012 in Adelaide at the World Championship. So these two have basically dominated fours at the World Bowls in recent years. And they're both of them quite capable of winning this final today. Obviously they're in the final, but you wouldn't count one as being a bigger favorite than the other. So in 2012, Aaron Sheriff, Mark Casey, Brett Wilkie and Wayne Rudiger, that was their combination then. So Wilkie and Casey back, and it was a completely different New Zealand four in 2008. Gary Lawson, Russell Meyer, Richard Gervin and Andrew Todd. So these two teams, very experienced players. The occasion won't overwhelm them at all. And it's just a matter of having used that quarter of an hour of warm-up, test ends, trial ends, to get to grips with this. And they're doing that now, as you can see by the green from those first two bowls. There or thereabouts. Nagy just a little bit shy with his first. So this is Barry Lester. These players we've seen before, Terry, haven't we, with the men's triples in a fantastic game. And Aaron Wilson we expect to be a real key to this combination for Australia. And I think you mentioned in the build-up there, Mike Kernahan, the experience of Kernahan and the fact that he can remain calm in tense situations will be good for the Kiwis.
Yeah, look, it is. It's certainly so. And just touching on Aaron Wilson, I think he put in a fantastic performance when they won the Piers Gold Medal for Australia. He is just such a confident young person. He's come through the age group bowls in Australia and now he's on the big scene and it hasn't fazed him at all. He's certainly put in some fine performances throughout this event over the last 2 weeks, and he continues it here today, getting through to the final. The New Zealand team, yeah, look, it's a good, steady combination. And as I mentioned earlier, Mike Kernahan, I think if he does everything I coached him and taught him in the game, he'll come through okay.
Well, the reference really, of course, is that Kernahan lives in Dunedin. He's from Dunedin initially and spent periods in Auckland and Wellington too, but is back in his home area. First met him in the Commonwealth Games on Victoria Island, or Vancouver Island in Victoria back in 94, where he was a member of the New Zealand team there. So very experienced.
Yes, the big thing about Mike is his delivery, and he always says, if I've got that right, the rest of it will take care of itself. And something that he always works on is ensuring that he gets his delivery correct. And a very good principle to have in the sport, because you no longer can you control the bowl after it's left your hand.
Drop it, yeah, mate. Triangle's good.
Kernahan has played a few aggressive shots in the games to date, playing at two for New Zealand. He's a very good singles player, and He's a skipper, as all these players are. They play all positions, but his draw bowls is really his forte. But he has been playing a few nice little run shots and early on in games, called on by his skip Ali Forsyth. First end, men's fours final, 2016 World Championships. Conditions haven't changed. It's quite warm out there.
Well played, Aaron.
Nice little play bowl there by Aaron Wilson.
Who's good.
Just one of the, going to be one of the best in the world. He's already in that area, and he's just such a complete player. This is Blake Signal.
Gently. Oh, fair attempt, mate. Come on, mate. Come in the area.
New Zealand playing with the red discs on their bowls. Australia the green. Blue.
Let's go. What you got now?
Dropping around him. Perfect here.
Up. Good. Hurry, disco. Up.
Well played, mate. That's great.
Building up quite nicely for Australia here.
Just drop a metre. Track's perfect. Inside half of the green. You get back to the jack.
Yes, Blake Signal doesn't have to change too much from his previous bowl. Just needs to have the weight catching on the shot bowls.
That down by a couple.
Good
boy. Blake Signal to the left of that group there from Stokes Valley. Doesn't play out of Stokes Valley these days, but is, that's where he played his early bowls and until recently. Parents Brian and Teresa, who do live in Stokes Valley, they're here watching, as of course is Peter Ballas, one of New Zealand's most outstanding bowlers, soon to become one of the coaches of the Blackjacks.
Well, mate.
Yes, Peter, he's been involved with the Blackjacks over the last couple of years and came on board with the coaching team when we were preparing for the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow. Peter, of course, had a huge experience of playing on overseas greens and is now coming into the role as an assistant coach, and will continue that in the new structure when Dave Edwards departs the scene as the head coach. Peter will take perhaps a little bit more senior role. Ali Forsyth looking to attack. He'll play one of his favourite shots, the running shot, weighted shots. He's pretty much in the target area.
Oh, he might have got both of them. He did get both those Australian shots.
A fantastic shot from Ali Forsyth, and gee, isn't that going to give him some magnificent confidence? Here we see it again, the two blue bowls in front. Look at them. It peeled the whole three of the Australian bowls off the head and left the one bowl that Blake Signal had played there as a shot.
So Casey, as was mentioned, this is his final big event for Australia. He's been a great player for this Australian team.
Go, dude. Final batting, green one.
So yep. Now we've still got one to play for Ali Forsyth. He's holding shot there. New Zealand playing with the red discs. So they've gone from three down to one up. Certainly two down at the time to one up. Changing from a run shot to a draw. Oops, he stopped, and you know he just stuttered. Kernahan pointing out, and he's asking for it to come in, pick it up even, sit on it. Didn't quite sit on it, just runs through a meter. Getting down to measure that second shot. No one seemed to be convinced of it. Certainly in your television angle, it doesn't look to be much in it. It doesn't look to be close, but they're much closer to it there. That doesn't come into the count. And this one might come into the measure. Two it is, in fact. Good measure. Worth the measure. Two.
Yes, just with the movement of that bowl, it gave Australia the two shots.
So a lot of family and friends here. There's Ellie Forsyth's mum and dad up there in the white caps, floppies. And his father's just probably leaning across to talk to one of Ali's uncles who's come out from England and is watching this event as well. So lots of family support. There we are. Uncle on the right with the California cap. It's Uncle Bruce. And we see the start of end number two now. New Zealand getting that nice little start at two on the first. 18 ends this men's fours final, and that's a loosener from Mike Nagy.
With his second, a little bit loose. And this is the second to end. Port that if you are going to be loose to be past the jack.
Go. Barry Lester, his first two, giving Australia that early advantage in the second end. Kernahan plays the backhand.
In the area. Gently now, Kearney. Gently, mate. Well played.
A ball from Kernahan first up.
Brilliant.
Following that bowl down, his own previous one was very handy indeed.
Right, good to there.
Kearney. Forsyth likes it.
Back to it. Down. Right shots, Kearney.
Oh, takes it nicely. Just moves the jack slightly. Makes it more solid for New Zealand. That jack, I think if shorter bowls there, we'll be just hiding that a little bit. It's the spray.
Yeah, some great balls there from Mike Kernahan. Just wondering, John, if this is the better side of the rink. It hasn't been played much in any of the finals, but the bowls always seem to be getting back. And as we see it from that bowl there.
I think we've constantly seen that last weekend and again this morning in our previous final. That back end of the right-hander was by far, it seemed to be the more stable side.
But, you know, going on this direction in particular, because invariably the hand that now Blake Signal is playing, if you go slightly too wide, you just don't get back to the jack.
Up and over, mate.
Run, mate.
It's pretty well pointed, though. Blake Signal, if he's got the weight. Oh, the line was real good, too. Well, they're building a reasonably nice head here, New Zealand.
Drop by.
One down.
Have Australia got anything over the head at all? I just, if we look at this I suppose that's Canterbury people will say, well, that's a nor'westery sky.
Down now, Baz. Down you go.
Inside the back one, mate.
So that's what we're looking at to see what was down there. I think that's...
It's only a foot, mate.
Yeah, one of each
the,
there, yeah.
Yeah, it was the first bowl of Mike Nagy that's gone to the back of the rink. So New Zealand just drawing. Great signal, he doesn't need much more weight than his last.
He doesn't need any more green either. And what we've found sometimes is putting on that bit of extra weight to take a bit of extra green.
And they go sailing on by.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's in the ditch. Wilson, he's tightened his line just a fraction.
Drop in, mate.
Woo. Wee bit of weight off it.
All right, let's go. Hold on, mate. All good there.
Good, mate. Good job.
So as we look down there, you see the situation is that Australia hold one shot, the blue disc bowl, which is closest to the jack. Then New Zealand have 3 seconds. Big umbrella of players standing around the bowls watching this as Forsyth. He's a left-hander, remember. So he's playing what is the forehand to the right-hander. We've seen a few play this side. Oh, what does he think about that?
It's supposed to be on a tight line.
Yeah, it looked tight.
It's a very fine line down that side.
Yes.
Was that come up short as well? Needed some more weight.
Just trying to draw onto that shot bowl. Is that the shot that he's playing? But now it's.
He's just got to be a little bit careful, Mark Casey. He doesn't want to be moving the jack. Just wondering whether he'll continue down this hand. He is. He certainly. On the mat, looking to continue on his backhand, left-hander, both the skips. Ducking in early as well. Right, so that's made it a little bit more difficult for Ali Forsyth.
Still there under the blue. Under the blue, isn't it? Yeah. Got to play with a yard or two to get under.
Casey's wife, Teresa, with the two kids, Jackson and Eva. Jackson and Eva not taking too much notice, but behaving. She did say, oh, I hope the kids behave. And they are. Forsyth.
Just a bit sharper now, Ali Forsyth. He has to get weight underneath his own bowl.
Getting on to his own. Mightn't do any damage. And if it hit that a bit square, it would have been okay, possibly. So still the one shot there to Australia.
Come on, Hammer. Come on, Case. Clear road.
Oh, they like this.
Clear. Clear.
Oh, nearly a perfect bowl. A single there to Australia, I think, is the call. And yes, it is. Here we see Aaron Hyde holding the lollipop, and that's a single to Australia. It's 2-1 after two ends. Interesting sky here. We've had a bit of a change in the weather. It's warmer. The wind has stayed up, nor'westery. And people sitting in the stand here thinking it's not really that hot, and now they realise that, yes, sun cream is advisable. Third end. New Zealand leading 2-1, the men's fours final.
Snelly. You're very good here, mate.
Basil.
Well played, Baz. Very good, pal. Killing you, mate. Your line's good. Go
again, mate. Yeah.
Okay. Good play, Barry. Snelly. Really get up, mate. Again. Two goodies,
Baz. Two good opening balls from Barry Lister. Certainly a better one here from Mike Nagy. He can get inside the blue disc bowls. He got the shot. He has. Well done, Mike Nagy.
Very good collection.
Yes, he's been a little bit loose in the opening ends, but a very good bowl there.
Yes, he was loose on that previous end. His first one coming this way was overweighted, but he corrected nicely to give New Zealand the early advantage.
Hurry now. Up.
Wilkie's been very consistent throughout. First from Kernahan, New Zealand's number two.
Just your pace, mate.
Oh, well short from Kernahan.
Good, mate.
You feel a bit of tension out there. You know, it's close as you'd expect, but these two teams have had such excellent rounds going, games going through the rounds to get to the final. They know each other's play so well. They know each other so well. And they both expect a big tussle here. They're demanding excellence from themselves. And you saw there Kernahan slapping his thigh because he's going to be short again.
Yes, just failed to make the correction on his first bowl. Pretty relaxed, Mike Kernan. I was talking to him earlier, and he says it's just another game of bowls.
Yep. That incidentally was a Welsh team and some of their family, the Welsh women finishing runners up in the women's triple earlier this morning.
Irish candies go. Bit more.
Weight's good.
Another one in there, mate.
Throw it
with confidence. You trail the first is good. You don't get to the air.
Forsyth indicating he doesn't want any more short. Wants it up there and just over the jack. He'd be happy. More on it would be even better.
Up and about, mate.
And he's played this well. Nice bowl from Blake Sidney.
Give a good chance.
Yes, well played, Blake Sidney.
Jack three. Can't get them both. A little touch on that. To the jack, mate.
All right. Request for Wilson to play with some weight. Reaching through it. Well, this looks to be wide. And come back. No.
Same program. You get to the jack just around the corner. Weight's perfect.
Yes, Ellie Forsyth explained it quite clearly there. If he can move the jack around the corner, there's going to be a lot of bowls in front of it. Had a very good bowl, Blake Sidney. One down with his first. as the players come up after the bowl. Change over for the skips to play their two bowls each.
Might just be a block, actually. It mightn't do exactly what he wanted. Ah, oh, it's just gone on a bit too far.
Get a hammer.
Didn't have the length, didn't have the weight. So there's a target there for Mark Casey. The back bowl belongs to Australia. So the bowl closest to the ditch will belong to Australia. If there is any movement of the jack, we'll see what Casey does here.
Got less weight than what Aaron Wilson played with. Given the bowl an opportunity to turn, he's pretty much on the target area.
There you go. Now it stays with it too. So that's the shot there. And you notice, I mentioned, the closest bowl to the ditch was an Australian bowl. So it's two to Australia there.
And the indicator is put on the bank there, which indicates where the jack is sitting in the ditch. We can't see the jack, but it's immediately underneath. We can now, the yellow jack there. And the bowl, of course, that Mark Casey played, having touched the jack, and the field of play remains a live bowl when it goes into the ditch. So Australia holding two shots.
So just drawing to the ditch. And the jack moved across a couple of metres from centre line.
If he's got enough weight, but it'll give him some indication as to if his second bowl needs another good metre of weight, just over a metre and a half.
Casey played a purler previously to take the jack into the ditch. His toucher stayed with it. It's in the ditch as the shot. That green bowl there also is Australia's, so it's the second closest. Here comes Casey. He's giving this plenty. Might have given it too much.
Yes, having to come off the run shot, back to the draw. It's not always easy.
You get 3 feet from the ditch, you count.
So Forsyth would dearly love to draw a shot, but the thing he's got to do is to, if he stay on the rink and at least cut it down by one. So he's aiming to get inside that green ball. If he gets within a metre or so of the ditch, he'll possibly claim the shot. See, Jack just starting to emerge there in the ditch. That's where he's heading for. Has he done it, given it too much or not? Too much. Too much. Too much. Just too much. Almost the perfect shot. Not quite. He needed to stay on, and he didn't. And so Australia take the lead now at 3-2 after three ends. Part of the Australian family there. Well, the good thing is at the end of the day, the Australians, no matter where they finish, will be presented with a little stuffed kiwi. Early stages of the fourth end, Australia leading in the men's fours final at World Bowls 2016. Warm but breezy in Christchurch at the Burnside Bowling Club. Mike Nagy. quite pleased to have sat on that initial Leicester ball.
Yes, he had a bit too much weight. I'm wondering whether any consideration will be given to Mike Nagy changing hands, going over to the side of the rink that Barry Leicester's on.
Good effort, mate. Shot, Baz.
Well done. Jack was good, mate. Top the pace.
Needs correction, Mike Nagy.
Reasonable. Up and over, mate. Hurry.
Let's go, mate. Stay hot. Stay high. Weight's good here, Wiz.
Can't rest while Wilkie's around. Brett Wilkie in early good form in this final. Mike Kernahan's daughter Kate is down from Hamilton to watch this, and his wife Jan is here as well, but you won't see her in the stand. She said, I just can't watch the stuff. She'll be pacing around the back somewhere, but she would have enjoyed seeing that.
It's interesting that Mike Kernahan stuck onto that hand that he drew two beautiful shots on, and most people would look at that and say that perhaps Aaron Wilson's bowl or Brett Wilkie's bowl, was in the way. He stuck to it because I think it just may be the better side of the rink going in this direction, and it was evidenced there by Mike's bolt. Played it very well. The players have just been battling on this.
And again, buddy, same time.
Side
yep,
of the
deep weight
so
either side of that bowl's a winner.
Yep, so that's good. So Forsyth's encouraging him to stay on that hand, and he's playing it well. It's from the mat, it's hard to gauge how big the gap is, and Forsyth just indicated that he had plenty of room to get in it. Through it.
Well, it's a simple principle. It's a bowl that's around about four inches across, 5 inches across, that you're trying to negotiate. And Mike Kernahan's done that with both of his bowls. Two very, very good bowls from Mike.
Oh, let's go, mate.
What that's done too, when we have a look at it from the view of the bowler, it's actually hidden the jack from sight. And Wilson's been down there having a look. He knows exactly where it is. No sign of a jack there. And he's playing, the side that he's played well, he's played this forehand quite well, Wilson.
Hurry. Good ball, Baz. Bottom
line. 18 inches.
Close for two, mate. Just got to draw away down here. Anywhere just past, you're going to be close to the tee.
That fraction wide out there on that hand.
You're just around it, mate. Just around with good weight, you get back. 2 feet and you last.
This will be interesting here because that bowl is very much close to being in the draw line. Mark Casey said it's just around it.
All the way.
And Aaron Wilson's looking to be pretty much on target, isn't he?
Run.
Hurry. Second.
Coming up short. New Zealand still hold the shots. Definitely got two, possibly even three.
Forsyth having a good look around. Kernahan throwing some input into the discussion.
Yeah, this is where the experience of Mike Kernahan comes into play. He will have an input.
draw into your second, and if he gets to the green, then happy days.
Yeah. You want 3 feet just under yours. You get back across
like
the line.
Happy days.
Get to ours, get to the
indicates that if it, the shot comes off, they'll be feeling good.
Yes, New Zealand will look at playing underneath the last bowl of Blake's signals. Doesn't want to go out wide and get onto the last bowl of Wilson. So tighten the line a little bit. Got opportunities narrow of the jack of still getting another shot. There he is coming now to the screen underneath and coming into a pretty good area.
Well, good effort there from Signal. He's consistent early in this game.
Yeah.
I think that you might see some attack here from Casey. New Zealand holding at least, well, probably two in two measures, but the front bowls, Casey will look at driving through. We can see the three bowls there. All New Zealand bowls.
So just looking at see what's the back bowl there, and it's just that one Australian bowl back there. We're going to play with a bit of weight here, and plenty of weight, plenty of weight. Down that centre line, no damage. From the New Zealand point of view.
Yes, the bowl right at the back we can see there is the Australian bowl, the green bowl of Australia.
Even if you're under the hair, mate, still be close to him.
Yeah.
Very good head building here for New Zealand.
Yes. So if Casey was able to move the jack straight back, then they had the back bowl, that green one. But when we look at where the jack is now, the three to the top of it are all New Zealand bowls. So you confidently say there's three shots there, but still bowls to be played. That's what New Zealand can do in this situation. So Forsyth will want to be he wants to be up there, not short.
Keep him on the tighter line, underneath the signal bowl. That's the one which he's heading towards now. He needs to duck under it.
Wow, look at that.
Well, that's a good bowl. That's a very good bowl from Ali Forsyth.
Parental acclamation there.
Three shots to New Zealand.
Here we go. Save the situation. Well wide from Casey. And with one bowl to play, it's Forsyth still to play one. New Zealand holding four shots there. On this, the fourth end.
Definitely three. Our indications from our lollipop lady who was off screen just put up three, but okay. Gee, it looks to be more, doesn't it?
Yeah. So for Forsyth, it's just more of the same. If he can still draw inside that black signal bowl, or is he going to get tied up in it this time? He is. It was his own that he pushed up. But we'll take out three, and Australia might say let's measure for that fourth. Well, that was pressure coming on by Signal in particular, wasn't it? Or Kernahan in particular. Then Signal built on that from the third position. It is four. Great end for New Zealand in the early stages of this men's fours final. A four on the fourth. They lead by 6-3. It's a well-known commentator, broadcaster, Leslie Murdoch there in the white hat. Hockey commentator at Rio Olympics and a lot of cricket for New Zealand. She'll be loving this. She said she was watching a lot of it last weekend, and here she is to support the New Zealand team. First bowl of the fifth end. Nagy's been loose, but he's corrected that. Just right on the line. Bit short. Barry Lester had a whole lot of, or group of club mates out here all during the first 2 weeks of play. His wife Miranda was here and a lot of club mates here as well until yesterday. They had to go back for some inter-club play or penance or something. So they've left him to do it on his own.
Wait, Nelly.
And he won't be worried at all.
Right up, buddy.
That's a very good opening bowl by Baz Lester.
Great shot, mate.
Come on, wifey, back again. Back again, mate. Really handy.
Come in, mate. Come on, all the way up, buddy. Very good shots here. Well done, mate.
Yeah, qualities of good leading.
Shot,
one on the jack and one over.
Forget, draw a shot. Easy now, interested. Kenny, dive. Oh, mate, very good.
Jack Hyatt, back to Kearney. Need to get down. Come on, Wiz. Hurry. Third.
Same old mate, touches three.
I think this is going to be an intriguing battle, Terry. There's some very good bowls being played here. Each of the players in their respective positions warming to the task nicely. We're playing the fifth end. And if you're looking at individual battles for various positions,
Kearney,
then they're having a great contest.
Oh,
hurry to the Turnahan. Well played, Kearney.
Oh, look at that. Yeah, he's been man of the match so far, hasn't he? He's played outstanding, Mike Kernaghan.
Right, see, that's
two
mate.
Very good bowls from there.
Off
he didn't
well.
Even change hardly anything to his second bowl. Little movement of the jack, making it difficult for Australia. Five bowls now in front of the jack, so Brett Wilkie's been called upon to try and open it up.
Down, Wizza! Oh, well done, mate.
He's taken one out.
New Zealand still holding one.
So signal being asked just to be over. Probably just matching that green ball at the back.
Easy target. Gently, mate.
He's going to be ditch weight.
Good chance
it's well, truly, well and truly ditch.
It's a loose one there from Blake. Doesn't want to be losing his bowl. Anything past the jack would be valuable. But ideally needs another one in on the head.
Go on, mate. Turn.
Good hitting really. Here too, so they've got a couple over the head
good,
and they're holding.
Good.
4 second shots. 4 seconds.
Settle.
Looks to be heavy again, Blake.
Yeah, he's got a get onto something there. No, no, no. He's
similar,
ditch again.
Yeah, he's failed to correct there. Well, a couple of the loose ones is Shannon McElroy and Amy McElroy. Due to have their first child, surely, too. So into the men's singles final tomorrow, Shannon. This is where Mike's experience comes in, isn't it? It's just, helping Blake out there. He had a couple of loose bowls, and just, come on, mate, don't need to worry about those. We've got another 15-odd ends to play yet, 14 ends. Just support there for him. There's Ali Forsyth on his backhand.
Sit, Mike. Two!
Hard luck. So that's very handy. That's where Forsyth really wanted signal in and about that area.
Yeah, that's our third shot. He's only got first and third, so cut out three of the Australian bowls that were in pretty handily to the jack.
Mate, change it up.
Mark Clayson playing with some weight
right now.
Oh, yeah.
What a shot, mate! Good shot.
Whoa,
well, good shot, buddy.
Where did it go to? Ali Forsyth's bowl, perhaps.
Yes, it looks like it from that angle, doesn't it? So, New Zealand was holding one, and the jack moves slightly as we watch it come in now on the replay. Hits the green bowl, squirts the jack across, it bounces back a little bit, but I think still favouring New Zealand. So that light blue ball in the centre of those is Ali Forsyth's.
So Ali Forsyth, we're presuming, is holding one shot at the moment. Needs to be very cautious.
Yes.
How far away his teammates are saying.
Up, run, run.
Coming up short.
Casey's still got one to go. I was looking at it, it's up on the bank. That last shot of Forsyth's strategically placed.
Unintentionally.
Yeah, but it's short and right on the line. We're right in line with the jack as we have a look now. See the light blue ball on the white line. So when Casey looks at this, he's going to play with weight. It's almost certain to get in his... From there, he looks like he can get round it, doesn't it?
Certainly so. There's an opportunity for him. Playing with a lot more weight this time.
Emma, very close here, mate.
Right in the target area. Oh, it's gone back up the green. Well, it's... probably two to New Zealand, I think. Yes, it is. Definitely two to New Zealand. Well, a little bit unlucky there, Mark Casey. He got right into the target area, hit the jack, hit the shot bowl. Jack going forward, back up the green. It's New Zealand who pick up two.
Well, we often say that short bowls are normally not much use, but look at that, that short bowl. Might be the first of Nagy's that was as well short, and it actually takes the shot. So they can occasionally come into play, but they're not encouraged. Scoreboard reads 8-3. So Nagy's obviously decided that the way his last end worked with the short bowl, Jack bounced back to him, he'll do it again.
Oh, I'd just love to see him change hands going in this direction. Get onto that hand that Mike Kernahan's drawing all the shots.
Just look better from Nagy. Yeah, he's up and over it, so he's just hasn't settled into his familiar groove as yet.
Lester, his second bowl on this, the sixth end, one third of the way through the game, up to 18 ends, the ends for his final.
There, green ball's 2 foot out.
So the bowl closest to the ditch now, if there's any movement backwards at the jack. Remember that bowl of Barry Lester there. Kernahan, who's bowled so splendidly on this hand.
Down you get, Kearney. Down hard, mate. Well played. Very good, mate.
You can almost sense Anali Forsyth's voice, can't you? His demeanour. He's just, he's almost not relying on Kernahan, but he's expecting from Kernahan all the time.
Yes, he must be excited to have him in the team here because he's performed so well in this final. His percentage of effective bowls would be huge.
On this out, mate. And again, Mike, same ball. How's the speed? Got to get past the front. Hurry! Come on, Kearney. Yes, you did.
Got it on a string, hasn't he?
Can't ask for anything more from your number two.
Hurry, Wiz.
Wilkie trying to match him now. Wilkie just, no, this is unlike Wilkie actually, and what we've seen from him over the last 2 weeks.
Just over 2 foot out there.
And Casey looking slightly anxious, but still plenty of bowls to come, and he does have Wilson as his next up. Here's Signal. See how the little encouraging talk from Kernahan worked for him. He put two in the ditch.
Easy Tiger.
Oh, I've just heard him say easy Tiger again. This is Forsyth.
Stay on, mate.
He's in the ditch again. Oh, that'll be... He's laughing about it, and he gets his another bowl, and he just doesn't want it there. This is Sharon Sims. We mentioned Peter Ballas before. Well, Sharon and Peter are taking over as the co-coaches of New Zealand bowls. As Wilson brings in his next.
That's not bad.
So New Zealand had the two over, back mate. Bowls here, but the one closest
that's
to the jack is
the
just
bowl.
Out of
good.
Shot was
here,
an Australian it. One. So Signal. Playing the other hand here, might be, he's going to take plenty of weight off anyway. He's not going to be in the ditch this time.
There's another couple of loose bowls from Blake Signal. Well,
Casey, good shot.
Yes. Casey calling on Aaron Wilson to open it up. Try and give myself an opportunity to attack. Well, see it now. He gets on in the blue bowl from Australia. Propels onto the New Zealand shot bowl. Goes through and lies beside the jack. Well, it was a good result for Australia. A little bit of a perhaps. Perhaps if I do this, that might happen. So I think Ali Forsyth now will look at playing with some weight towards the shot bowl. His teammates look on. On his forehand, Ali Forsyth.
Hunting the shot bowl of Australia's.
Yeah!
Got it, clean. And the jack into the ditch and follows it.
Yeah, it was a great shot from Ali Forsyth. He got maximum result out of it when you're right on target like that. Takes the jack through to the ditch. And there's also a New Zealand bowl at the back of the rink there. We can see at the blue disc bowl. Australia. Yes, that's the Australian bowl. The New Zealand bowl's further up. There we are, following through. And virtually unbeatable.
Casey, the first of his two. Nice. This is the sixth end. 8-3 down on the board. One down on the head. Looking to draw. Is Forsyth looking at other options here rather than the draw? That green ball, is it worth anything?
Well, it's probably only worth one shot, but sometimes it becomes easier to play that blue disc bowl into the ditch, and perhaps if he gets some correct weight, he may just stay on the green himself. So pending as to how much weight he needs, the line that he takes, he's got to negotiate a bowl up the green on the left hand side. We can see we're playing with just enough weight to try and sit it into the ditch and stay there himself.
So his target is the green bowl right on the ditch.
Yeah.
He's got it. Oh. So it's given New Zealand two with one to play from Casey.
That was a great bowl from Ali Forsyth. If he'd got it dead square, he would have stayed on the green himself.
Casey drawing to save. Two shots here. He wants to get inside that last bowl of, or the New Zealand bowl, which is still there, the black one. Wants to get inside that black one. He's not going to, and so that's two shots to New Zealand. They go to double figures now. 10-3. Well, that was an intriguing end, wasn't it? And going through, running through what the players can see down there, their options. 10-3. Steve Glasson just talking to his Australian team on the bank. Glasson on the left there, the coach.
Yeah, it was Mike Kernahan and Ali Forsyth who played the outstanding bowls. All four of their bowls were so effective on that last end. Just lead Mike Nagy and late signal. Up their game a little bit. Handy opener from Nagy.
That's the New Zealand coach Peter Ballas down there and Blake Signal alongside. Coaches tend, well, certainly the New Zealand coaches tend to have little input unless asked for, really. Possibly in the case of Signal, just with those two ends of really awful bowls. It's just a bit of time out.
Same again, right?
Yeah.
run hard, mate.
Run.
Well played.
Yes, good ball from Barry Lester. He didn't worry about the New Zealand bowl that may have been in his line. Drew up and around it.
Now Kernahan.
Steady.
Kernahan is just a bit heavy this time, but at least he's up and over.
Yeah, mate, close you can.
It's in the right spot, though.
You can probably hear the wind in through our microphones here. It is a wee bit, well, a bit windy, but the players, as they say, this is what they expect. They've played in Christchurch a lot, and it's not often they've had in the last 2 weeks days without wind. There's a shot, two shots now to Australia. They have the blue disc balls. Just watch Kernahan. Playing on the forehand here and the right-hand side to the right-hander. See that line going through the top corner of that graphic on the ground. You can see how it starts to just curve in, turn in.
Hurry now.
Through the hole, up. Just a bit short this time. So he overcompensated, but not by much.
Okay, mate.
Saw that bowl of Wilkie's just went outside that top corner, so just a slightly wider line to what Kernahan was using. They're probably using totally different bowls. And you see it just going slightly wider on that line. It's taken him a bit wide on that hand. It's a signal now. What's going through his mind? Professional. Every player goes through a spot where they would like to correct and rectify things. They try harder and harder. There's another in the ditch.
Yeah, he's just struggling at the moment. Blake Signal just needs to settle down. Maybe just needs someone like Mike Kernahan to stay up with him there, give him a little bit of a confidence boost.
I suppose the good thing is that with Kernahan and Forsyth playing so well, it's not quite so much pressure, but they really do need to have someone building up the front, and at the moment there's nothing.
Yes, it's, New Zealand's a bit loose on this end. They need something from Signal now.
Hold for it, mate.
Need to hold on that. That'd be good. Yeah, he's bounced back. Good shot there from Signal. And I think I can be wiping his brow here. A wry smile. It's been two horror ends for him.
Yes, it certainly was. He was a little bit fortuitous getting onto the Australian bowl that was second shot, curving back in towards the jack and then falling over. So he got all the advantages then. However, it may just give him a little bit of confidence.
Yep. Playing the seventh end of the fours final. That was one of Nagy's balls, those short ones. Or might have been Kernahan's, in fact, that they played onto there. Forsyth has seen this. He sees that he's holding shot. That's the shot of Signal, which is fractionally past the jack, and that's the shot. And Forsyth playing now.
Stay high, mate.
To be anywhere near.
Ah, loose one from Ali. May have some effect.
Oh,
Not happy with it, Mark Casey. He knows he's gone wide for that weight.
Go, Ellie.
Yeah, mate.
Each skip has one to play. Forsyth can draw this, go to two. He can just rest on the second Australian shot and possibly bring a third New Zealand bowl into play. He's first of all got to
get over the top of me.
Improve on his last.
Can get past the front bowl of New Zealand. That's the one he has to negotiate. Well, he got up to third shot, I think. So, help for New Zealand. There's not too many options here for Mark Casey. As we see him, the study of the situation, him and Aaron Wilson, in deep discussion. It doesn't look good from Mark Casey's perspective, looking from the other end. That's what the view that he does see. It's just very much going to have to look at trying to dead draw the shot. Wait, he sees something on his forehand, looking for connection onto these front bowls.
Great effort, buddy.
Okay.
New Zealand has now scored on the last four ends. Nine shots on the last four ends. They lead by 11-3. But we're not yet at the halfway stage, and lots of things can happen. New Zealand up by 11-3 over Australia. The seven ends gone. This is the start of the eighth. Some of the players just feeling the pinch a wee bit out there. It's a tense match. A lot at stake. Really loose up until now. I don't think Ali Forsyth thought he was going to need the chalk at any stage for Mike Nagy, but he has struggled a fair bit over the first half dozen ends. That's a pretty good one. And Karen Murphy, nice to have you back. This is tense, isn't it?
It's very tense, John. It's, what a start, hey? 11-3 to the Kiwis.
Anywhere past, mate. Get to the air's good.
But even though all these players have played a lot of international bowls, you sense that some of them just feeling a bit tense out there.
Yeah, I also think too, John, that these guys play each other all the time. You know, Trans-Tasmans and Asia-Pacific games. They're so well known to each other that when it's on the line, Trans-Tasman rivalry. It's there is some tension out there, that's for sure.
That's a big hello again to our viewers through Australia and Fox Sport, and also on live streaming. We're seeing some fantastic bowls on this end. We've seen some top shots throughout, but some very loose ones. But this might be the tightest end so far as the leads strike form. Kernaghan now for New Zealand.
And a fist pump from Barry Lester. He was pretty happy with that one. That's exactly what the Aussies need at the moment. Some more of that.
Back again now. Very good, Kearney. Hurry. Yeah, good, mate.
Inside that, mate. Good two.
It's quite humid out there this afternoon. I'm not sure whether it might have a bit of a affecting the green a little bit.
Sorry, Wiz. As far as you can, mate.
Our boys haven't played that well going in this direction back to the Burnside clubhouse.
Well, Alec, again, as we mentioned earlier, there are individuals who have struggled a wee bit going this way, and some have been sitting here saying, gosh, you know, play the other hand maybe, you know, as a lead. If it's if you're not going so well, then the option is, isn't it? It's there to play down that other hand, which appeared to be the backhand to the right-hander, appeared to be playing a bit more surely.
Well, we've seen Mike Kernaghan draw a couple of really good bowls on this back end, and he's on it again.
Drop, mate, you're close.
Oh, he's close again. Call from Ali Forsyth.
Oh, very good, mate.
Oh, great effort there, Mike Kernaghan. Two to the Aussies.
Little shot, mate.
Conditions quite good for this afternoon's finals. Not too blustery. The wind sort of, it's consistent. Doesn't seem to be affecting the bowls too much on the rink.
Oh, that's a good effort, mate.
Chill, mate. Chill.
Good. Well done. Very good.
Just wanted something over that.
Confident draw, Blakey. How's that coming in, mate? If you get into this here, it's all good.
So Signal, who's had a mixed bag. Oh, another in the ditch. It's his fault. Greenkeeper.
Blake Signal's been a real, you know, he has been a stalwart of the New Zealand team for a while. I've been really impressed with him over the last 12 months or so. He's really, really improved. He's a good player, Blake. Not quite on the money with his last bowl, but he's heading up to speak to Ali now, discussing what shot they're going to play.
Won't want to ask him to play with weight because he already is.
Not sure if that was intentional
No, that's exactly right. Well, there's a shot there for him. You can see the jack now and he comes back on the mat. Australia holding a couple. He has narrowed it up a bit.
What about your speed from there?
He's trying to get back.
Oh, not quite.
Don't play much better, mate. Same ball.
Okay, mate, good.
Aaron Wilson, Disco, as we affectionately call him, doesn't waste too much time on the mat.
No time at all. In fact, quite often the other bowl hasn't finished and he's in there.
Boys
he's
are
played
in
that well. That's a beauty.
Well, it's close, isn't it?
So two shots, Australia.
Another one in there for the Aussies. I can't believe Ali's still got his jacket on. It's actually really warm out there on
the
outside.
He probably doesn't realise he's got it on.
Oh, jeez.
But it is quite muggy out there, and that wind, it's not belting into the trees as much as it was. Forsyth has adapted to the role of skip pretty well for this four. For a long time, New Zealand singles representative. Just crossing the white line now. He's onto something. He moves it around a wee bit. And might well have given New Zealand the shot.
Well, Ali Forsyth's weighted shots are phenomenal. Like, he's one of the best hitters, I think, in the game. And he doesn't go massive weight. He just plays controlled weight, but he's rarely, rarely sort of missing by, you know, a distance. He's always in the area. He's amazing. Amazing, you know, player when it comes to weighted shots. I think the boys, Aussie boys, would be cringing when he lines up.
three balls to be played. We're playing the eighth end, coming up to the halfway stage of this final, this gripping final between Australia and New Zealand. The title of world champion at stake, and here's Casey. The hole is too big. So how do you see that? That's two to New Zealand, maybe three. Well, is that
it's close
right-hand bowl, New Zealand's? Yes. The black one?
Yep. Close to three.
Yeah.
A good two and a measure at the moment, I think.
So is he looking to build on that, or is he looking to ensure that there's no opening for Australia?
Well, holes are good at this stage. I don't think Ali would want to fatten the target up too much. He's on the forehand, which would suggest that that's what he what he's playing that hand. He doesn't want to fatten the target too much.
Gently, mate.
Gently. Might be just trying just to get around that pack.
Not quite. But it's in there. Now, Casey found the gap last time. The back bowl near the ditch, I think, is New Zealand's.
Well, it's just a draw shot for mine, for Case. I think he really needs to just try and draw this. It was probably a fraction heavy with his last bowl. The boy's quite keen on this.
Yeah, and they should be. They should be. Oh, the hole again for Casey. Very unlucky. Two to New Zealand. It is indeed. So New Zealand on a roll at the moment, and Australia will be just intent now on holding them and getting onto the board. They haven't scored in the last five ends, and New Zealand lead by 13-3.
Well, Mark Casey can't take a trick at the moment, unfortunately, for the Aussies. He's had Jacks go back up the green. He's going through holes and things at the moment. Need to change this this momentum round.
You wait all time.
It's Mark Casey's final he was after.
Today with us. Wife Teresa and the kids and his in-laws and
right up here, Baz.
Grandfather-in-law, Reese. He's come down from Pataparam to watch and support.
You're pretty good. Hurry now. Come on, wifey. Right up. Up. Well played, mate.
Well, a good time for Mike Nagy to strike some form. Just those little personal battles, and we talked about that this morning, Karen, about, you know, lead against lead, two against two, and so on. Wanting to beat the opposition, beat the other. That's their own personal little targets. And if you're a mile away, you end up giving that advantage away. And you really want to, at the front of it, be setting things up for your skip.
Confident draw to the 2 metre, mate, if you happen to change it up.
As we saw this morning in the women's triples, often the front end of Wales gave the skip nothing to play for, did they?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, the team who puts the initial pressure on the opposition, you know, generally is the team that, you know, succeeds, and it all starts with the lead, that's for sure.
Come on, mate. General areas.
Mike Nagy's played the last two ends very well for New Zealand.
Hurry some more. Yeah, good, mate. You run it in, mate. You get this.
That's some hat Mike Kernighan's got on there, isn't it?
Yeah, never without it. I don't think it's a new one.
Looks like a fishing hat.
I think it's one that he's uses a lot.
Get it right, buddy.
Good shot, Jack, into the ditch.
Well, he's got the ricochet off the back Aussie bowl. If he hadn't got that, it was straight in the ditch. Oh, nothing going for the Aussies at the moment.
And again, mate, pass yours is good.
I think there is a toucher in the ditch, isn't there? The toucher stayed in the ditch at about centre. And the jack was just out past this the boundary mark. It's replaced. And New Zealand have the closest bowl to the tee, the 2 metre mark, when it's respotted. Is Kernahan again looking dangerous?
Starting point. Hurry now!
Great shot, Kernahan.
You go again, mate. Either of those two.
Mark Casey's called for a weighted shot from Brett Wilkie. Aussies on the attack. Looking for the toucher onto the jack here. Any contact?
Great effort.
He's opened it up a little bit, but still, it's a frustrating time for Australia. Good shot previously, took the jack into the ditch, but just out of the ditch when it was respotted at right next to a New Zealand bowl. Forsyth asking for something up and over the jack.
Track, pal. Hurry now. Come on, Blakey, all you've got. Sprint.
Oh, he's put it right where he wants it. Just on another metre, maybe, but that's pretty good.
That's perfect. Perfect from Blake Signal. Aaron Wilson's had a shave for the final. He's lost his handlebar moustache.
Yes.
Looks about 8 years old.
That's right.
Well, a little bit of weight from Disco here.
Come on.
Boys like it, needs to hold.
See the jack.
So he's improved the situation, though. It's two shots.
Oh, mate. Wouldn't change too much if you wait. You know, you get the jack round the corner.
A break for some of the workers here from Sky and also Bowls New Zealand. As Blake Signal played a good bowl last up. Did exactly what his skip wanted, something just over the jack.
Up your line for it, mate.
Well, he'd be looking to maybe just to touch it around the corner and tidy it up here, John.
Whoa.
A little bit of pace on it.
Hard luck. That was a fraction of an inch out. If the jack had gone with him or tucked it behind those other two New Zealand bowls, that would have been hard to get out for Wilson. He's quickly into his work.
Draw shot, just anything, turning the green bowl just in around it would be perfect here from Aaron Wilson. Looks to be tight.
Well, as they say, that's what skips are for. Tidy this up, please.
That's right.
There's a lot of room in there, isn't there? And Aaron Sheriff quite relaxed.
Little yawn.
Yeah, a bit of music going through the heads, I think. Forsyth now back to the mat. That's what he's left. And you would suggest that that bowl at about 5 o'clock, as we look at it, is the shot bowl and the New Zealand bowl.
Well, I think Ali Forsyth would be looking to draw a toucher. A front toucher would be fairly handy right now. It's on its way. Fraction heavy, line was good.
Yeah. There's no damage there, though. See, New Zealand's got the four back bowls.
Well, I'd be backing Mark Casey to draw this.
Yes.
Yeah, he's got a bit of room. Great shot of the venue here at Burnside. Stands are packed today. Kiwis are playing. Sun's out.
Yeah.
Great, buddy. Track, mate.
Here he goes. He's got his own ball.
First part, hammer.
Just in front. Oh, no, in his goes. Line. He can touch that, roll it over. He's going to go round that, is he? Or onto it? Round it.
Of it.
Nicely done. Oh, hard luck. That really is. That looked to be going into the perfect spot. Teresa just deep breathing up there as she rides every ball.
I can understand Case's frustration at the moment. Just nothing coming off for him.
And sometimes, in any sport, sometimes that just happens, doesn't it?
Just happens, you know, just have those days where, yeah. You know, nothing goes for you. I wonder if the boys, if the New Zealand boys are looking at the Aussie closest bowl here.
Hmm.
I was going to say, if I get a foot now, I should sure get a pace out of that.
Beating that
ball, yeah. You have to, of course, remember that Casey still has one to play.
Well, there's a fair bit of room there. Yeah. I think it's just a draw shot for Forsyth.
And if it, yeah, they're pretty well covered when you look at it from there. He's got a couple down to the left-hand side behind the jack as he looks at it. If the jack does move at all, but then I've got to be aware of what Casey will do next up. Let's see this last one from Forsyth.
His weight looks better on this one. Just needs to negotiate the front bowls here. Well, that hasn't made Mark Casey's job any easier. Really just has to play the same bowl as he did last in. I think Johnny's roll the green or just around it.
Final bowl on this, the ninth end. New Zealand holding shot. Casey looking to change this, get a bit of fortune here, some good fortune.
Well played,
right? He's close here.
Oh, he's played this well. He's played that very well. What a top skip shot from Mark Casey. Final match for Australia after a stellar career for the green and golds.
The look of relief on Mark Casey's face there, priceless. Boys are just in a huddle, just talking about tactics, what they're going to do. Plan B now. As Mark Casey's just draws the absolute shot there. Perfect weight for it. Flops in for shot.
So what immediately Lester has taken note, Matt right back to the 2 metre mark.
Jack. Okay, mate. A little bit shorter than they've been playing in this direction, not on the tee. Change of tactics for the Aussies. Well, we're halfway through, John. Plenty of ends to go.
Oh, yeah, tons of ends.
Plenty of ends to go.
Yeah. Nine ends gone, halfway stage. 18 ends and the men's fours final. The score mightn't look like it, but this has been a very tense match. 13-4. Australia went five ends without scoring, and now they have the mat and the jack after collecting a single on the night. 13-4.
Of course, the Blackjacks have Shannon McElroy in the final of the men's singles. It's a great effort for Shannon to get to the final. There's always that tiny little bit of, you know, home turf pressure, I suppose, but watched him play yesterday against Aaron and he was a class act.
There he goes.
There he is.
His wife watching relaxed today. He certainly had a big grin on his face last night when he eventually won that match, picked up the winning shot, 21-17, I think the final score was.
Really nice friendship between Aaron and Shannon as well. I know they're very good mates. They were texting each other last night and, you know, really healthy respect for each other. And I'm sure Aaron's very happy for Shannon to make the final, for sure. Well, none of those the match winner yet or the end winner yet, I don't think. A little bit of a loose end from both leads. Change of length. Well, this looks fairly handy for Brett Wilkie. Just running over.
Left it, mate.
Lock your leg, Ernie. Yeah. Be the last ball, mate.
So Kernahan has been the glue in this team, really. His draw play has been quite remarkable in the first half.
He's got such a smooth delivery, Mike Kernahan. Gets it away out like a shoot.
Drop hard, Kearney. A little bit more. Yeah, good
mate. That's the result.
Saying before his wife Jan doesn't watch. She's here, but she doesn't watch. She's one of those who cannot watch. I said she should be watching this because her husband's playing beautiful bowls.
He's on song today. Almost like a fixed stance delivery from Kearney. He really plants his foot and then his all arm comes through after his foot's planted.
Just never changes. He's
very effective.
Very smooth. Effortless delivery.
The Aussie contingent willing their men's fours to gather some momentum here in the fours final.
Might just come from Wilson. Not quite. Again, that's just not working Australia's way. Shot still belongs to New Zealand.
Well, whoever jumps on it first in this end, just going to stamp their authority for this end because there's really nothing too near it at the moment. Up. Kiwis hold one.
That's good, mate. Let's go.
There's plenty of room.
Good.
As we spoke about before, too, John, this forehand going back to the club on the right-hand side of the ring just holds off a little bit. Not a lot of turn on it. Look at this. It's just not getting down there.
And I just wondered when they brought the jack out a bit, shorter end, or that's at maximum, but that might have influenced a bit, but it's not, is it? It's the same even 3 metres out.
Still reacting the same as if it was on the tee.
Yeah. Signal looking for something close.
To be honest, there's not really any other option to play the other hand for the Australians. No. They really need to play this. Just getting under Blake Sigel's last bowl, dropping in underneath the white bowl.
So a lot of statistics are taken on these games, aren't they? Australia's got someone over there working on a computer and dotting, marking every bowl that's played, and New Zealand will be doing the same.
Statting bowls. Any little one percenters that any country can get on each other.
Mark Casey's had to play some very difficult shots.
Aussies do have 2 seconds here. Any contact on the white bowl of Aaron Wilson's here. Could make 3 shots. Jack back is good too. Just underneath it.
I see, yes. So those 2 green bowls back there. In fact, 4 green bowls of Australia. Over there, Jack. Movement would see that, all those blue disc bowls down there. If the Jack moves back towards the ditch, towards the shadow of the big thingamy that Storm's working at the moment there. We should get a shot of Storm working on that machine, or the two big boys working the machines. Those, what are they called? Jimmy Jibs. So here we go now with Forsyth, aware of that danger.
Ellie be looking to just get into that pack of green bowls. If he if he falls short here, we'll draw a shot, which he has. Well, he's got back to the line there. That's a great bowl from Ellie Forsyth.
Very good shot. Ellie Forsyth, he's again limited the options for Casey. I think two shots, did you pick it as that? Oh, there we go. There's the boys doing the heavy work. Sam at one end and Storm at the other.
Storm, he's always got his guns out. Sun's out, guns out.
Yep. There we go. Casey, second to last bowl of this end.
It's just not getting down at all on that hand.
No, it's not coming. So now, Forsyth, just do what you did last time. There we are. Storm, give us a wave, Storm. Come on. Don't be shy.
The guns
thank you.
Out. Good. It's a wave.
No matter what the weather, he's got the guns out.
He's got the guns out if it's 6 degrees or 26.
Yep. Mind you, I do think that's the only top he's got.
He told me he had five of the same top.
Oh,
they're
did,
all
yeah,
just
yeah.
black singlets.
Yeah. Forsyth on the draw.
Well, a fair bit of room for Ali to really add to this count here.
I don't think he likes it. I
just
think he's heavy.
Going,
he's flying through. A couple there, I think it is. Two New Zealand, two shots, so they're back on the board. 15-4. Australia are defending the title they won in Adelaide in 2012.
Plenty of ends to go for the Aussies too, John. Like, I mean, they you know, they get a count of, you know, a four or a five here, and they're right back in it.
Oh,
you
absolutely,
know, 15,
yeah.
15-9, yeah. Six behind, plenty of ends to go. You know, they just need a count or a bit of momentum. A couple of ends on the trot. The Kiwi outfit certainly playing well today. Led off by Mike Nagy, lives in Australia, in Sydney.
Howdy here, mate. Good, Mike. Happy, mate.
Come on, Baz.
I think we might get Terry Scott to come back in and just wave a big piece of cardboard or something just to stir the air around a bit. But Karen, it's quite hot in here, isn't it?
It's hot in the commentary box.
Yep. Well, thanks, Terry. Good. Always takes a hint.
At least we're losing some weight. That's good.
Yeah.
Barry Lester here. Body language not great after he let that go. Although, doesn't look too bad. Needs to run.
A bit more.
Zoe. Play, Ben.
Same ball, mate.
Also, we call Barry Lester Snelly. So if, for the bowls enthusiasts out there, John Snell was an Australian legend bowler. He's Barry's idol. So
run hard.
Barry's got the nickname Snelly, or Snello, as he's been called a couple
get,
of times Mikey. This week.
Up you get.
Snelly cakes.
Yeah, call him that. Stuff, everyone buddy. Thinks you said, what? Smelly. Yeah.
Beautiful delivery Barry Lester has. Very smooth. Lets it go the same every time. He's in the area here.
Yeah. He's just yes. added that bit well, onto it.
Yeah, great correction there from Barry Lester.
That's what we expect from Barry Lester.
He looks better down there, Kearney. Just confident draw, mate. Inside the pole, we trail.
Shanahan taking that back foot right to the edge of the mat when he delivers that smooth style of his. Just sit the jack. He's just cutting the line a bit early.
Get with him, mate. Confident that up there. You trail our hole. Land theirs. Even if you trail, it's good.
Looks like he's got a bit on this one, Brett Wilkie. Correction quick.
Ball just fell, mate. I'm happy for you to lose your ball now.
Just asking a bit of aggression from Kernahan.
Wow.
Oh, now that's really picked up.
Feels almost a little bit stormy.
Yeah.
Here you don't see too many storms in Christchurch, not that I've seen. We get some big storms in Sydney and on the Gold Coast.
There he goes, looking for the shot. Has he picked it, or the jack? Just a bit fine. Might still get something out of it. Not quite.
Ooh.
Opened it up down a wee here, bit. So Australia holding shot. New Zealand with a couple of seconds.
We probably are more chance of having an earthquake than a storm, John, aren't we?
Yep.
Yeah. Although we've been pretty lucky the last
couple
of weeks.
Have you felt a few while you've been here?
The first night, that was the only one, and I'm fairly happy with that ratio.
Yeah. Fair enough. Yes, they're not much fun, are they?
Still a few days to go yet.
Yeah, that's right.
I think you go pretty firm for that. Jack will bowl, hit the back one as well.
Brett Wilkie with the family at Pacific Pines are all keenly watching and hoping that this Australian team picks up the pace now at 15 to 4 down. You see Signal with a bit of pace here. Gets it, gets a shot bowl. That'll give him some confidence after a few that weren't so good earlier in the match.
Pressure back on Aaron Wilson now as Blake Signal just bowl end over end. Out clean, no jack. Looking for a really good draw shot here from Disco.
It comes sort of a third of the way, or a quarter of a way down the rink following it.
A little bit of weight on it.
Yeah.
Good, mate. That's a metre off the ditch. You try and match that. You get past it, obviously perfect.
That's what we call a good sighter for your second bowl. Nail the line, yard off, and he's very close.
Decent road, mate. How far you coming? Hurry now. All you got. Hurry. Push hard. Good, mate.
Well done, mate.
Move off yours. Very close, mate.
Good to be able to hear the comments from the skips. You know, hurry, give us all you've got. He wanted it right up towards the ditch, close to the ditch if he could.
Let's go. In the area here, buddy.
Well, he's up to it again, mate. Aaron Wilson. Edge off the...
Clear that. All right, buddy.
Good effort.
It's in the count. That might have cut it down, actually. Karen, it's still New Zealand with the shot. The skips to play. This is the 11th end. So looking at those back bowls there, two to the left are Australia's. New Zealand has one in there as well. A couple there. Four
Forsyth with his first. He's been in fine touch today.
He has been on song, Ali Forsyth.
To come inside that Australian bowl, settle in there. That's all right there, I would imagine, he's thinking. But there's still a big gap there, and Casey has played a couple of really good draw bowls.
We just played one very similar going in this direction 2 ends ago. The Aussies desperately need him to do it again. Hails from Club Helensvale, Mark Casey, as does Brett Wilkie.
Come on, Case, hold now.
He's got it, is he? Just inside and into the ditch.
Imagine there'll be a few supporters at Club Helensvale this afternoon. Big shout out to everyone there watching the Aussie boys.
Yes, they'll be gathered around and enjoying this. It's tense stuff. This really is, as I mentioned earlier, 15-4. It doesn't look as though it's been a close game, but it has been. It's been absolutely gripping.
Played this well.
Beautiful from Ali Forsyth.
Perfect. Inch perfect from Ali Forsyth.
Close for two. I think you changed, mate. You've got to play for the jack.
Same job, mate.
You get the jack off. In your three, you change
not
the game.
Far off. Get it.
Well, the same direct from Aaron Wilson.
Yeah, same shot from Mark Casey. Even edge off the shot bowl for the jack down there for three. Aussies. Jack in the ditch. Could really get him back into this game if he was able to pick up a three, taking the score to 15-7. They're not out of it. These are really hard shots to play on these greens, this type of weight.
You can hear he doesn't like it. Narrow. And now we see a measure. One out. Closest of the tried to stretch it.
Lined up like little soldiers, aren't
they? Yeah. Umpire. Well, they measured
three.
It's a three. Goodness me, that's a bit deceptive as we viewed it. 18-4 New Zealand now. A three on the 11th. Nice sunshine here at Burnside in Christchurch. It's the venue for the finals of World Bowls 2016. The men's fours final. Played 11 of the 18 ends, and it's New Zealand leading by 18-4.
Well, we've really seen two games of one-sided games, I suppose, today in the finals. Well, the Aussie girls were too good for the Welsh girls in the triples final. And the Kiwi boys here just playing very well.
a good batter.
You're dropping a foot, buddy.
Two finals on each of the last 2 days of the championship, and already the women's triples this morning, won by Australia over Wales. Tomorrow, it's the women's pair.
Mike's really good, pal.
The men's singles.
Good shot, Mike. Good, Mike.
Nagy finds his weight.
The women's pairs final will be interesting too. Obviously, the Kiwi girls, Joe and Angela, are playing the Welsh. Interesting game. Is it correct? The Welsh haven't dropped a game yet.
They went through unbeaten.
That's fantastic.
Certainly, one of the teams did. From that.
Fantastic effort.
Wasted again.
Pick your hand, Curdy. Happy either side, mate.
Pick your hand. Well, he'll be playing that backhand because he's played it as often as he can. He's played it very well.
And immediately Mike Kernahan goes to that left-hand side of the rink. Oh, I'd like to see Barry Lester change to that side.
Another
I think, John.
And
he's really, he hasn't been going too badly, but just that, when the Jack's on the tee down there, just not getting back. And an example of those is his first two bowls there, just a little bit lazy. As though Brett Wilkie's done the same here. Starting to get down. It was probably more his weight that time.
Thank you there, mate. Draw away, draw to that ball. If you do get back to Jack, bonus.
Changing hands, his own ball was a bit short. It was an unusually loose ball for Kernahan. See how he goes coming in from this hand.
Down again, Kearney. Oh, mate, fair attempt.
Just scoots along as we've spoken about.
Yeah.
Well, plenty of room here for Brett. He's certainly narrowed the line up there. Not sure if he's going to hang around. Well, perfect weight, just a foot or so short.
We're just down. Draw a shot there. Little touch is brilliant. You're in the ballpark, mate.
This is close.
Come on, Blakey.
Oh, that's the one.
All right, John.
After a really bleak patch over three or four ends, Blake Signal comes back just as Kernahan faltered for a change on one end. Signal's filled the gap.
Fantastic to see the progress that Christchurch has made too, John, like in the rebuild, and it's great to go into the city now, and there's lots of new restaurants and cafes, and it's great to see. Really good.
It seems to be slow but impressive what they're doing.
Yeah, definitely. It's got a new vibe about it.
Yeah.
It's really lovely to see.
On the high side to the green bowls.
I know the families of the Aussie guys have spent a bit of time doing some sightseeing around the city and been very, very impressed, had a great time here.
All right, mate. So, mate.
Ball just fractionally wider in delivery from Signal and ends up well wide at the end. Turn around and Wilson's in on the run, having a go, and he's going to get the Jack, moves it to himself, to Australia. So a shot there for Australia.
Good shot, mate.
Situation's changed on the head now. It's Australia holding shot.
Play
weight
to get back to the deck.
Have
you go quick for the edge?
Yep. Ali's going the bowl here. Quick for the edge was the call. Might have definitely 1 second. Close for the other one. And the way he's been playing, he would back Ali Forsyth to get this.
...18-4 up on the board. One down on the head, New Zealand. Forsyth looking for that shot or the jack. The shot's the one he can see. In fact, he's cleaned out all round. Those are two New Zealand bowls sitting there, but that, I think, on the left is an Australian bowl. So there goes the shot.
Great weighted shot from Ali Forsyth. He's $1.04 at the moment with his hitting, I think. When the
So Casey goes to the mat now and well aware that his opponent is in a hot vein of form. And he has to put one back.
Jack high, mate. Jack high. Hey. More.
Not even by the back door.
Weight was pretty good.
What club has Australia been hosted by? Have you got, you're not here at Burnside, are you?
Yeah, we're at Club Papanui.
Oh, good.
So, yeah, the club that was being rebuilt. They've really looked after the Aussie team, and we've been we've had dinner there a few times. We've encouraged our supporters to go and have a look at the club.
Yeah.
Very good. So thanks to Club Papanui for having us.
Forsyth already with one beaut shot, giving New Zealand the shot.
Bit of a loose one from Ali Forsyth, I think. I don't think he was trying to play a blocker.
Well, not that short, I wouldn't have thought either, but well.
Uncharacteristic, but he's human.
He's in the road, though, but Casey.
Well, he's wider this time, Mark Casey. He's in the area here.
His weight looks good. He's on to it. He's on to it. He's done it. Oh. The rub of the green goes against Australia here, and New Zealand pick up another shot.
Reduce the count, though.
Yeah. Reaching for the measure once more. So Casey has had to play some rescue shots.
They're just not coming off for him at the moment. Mark Casey. I mean, that was a fantastic shot.
Very good. A single and it's 19-4. New Zealand leading Australia. We've played 12 of 18 ends. And the story of the match really is that from the fourth to the 12th end, New Zealand has scored on all but one of those ends, and Australia have managed to pick up just a single. So it really has been New Zealand in a dominant run of form, but there's still six ends to go in this final. Australia need to score a few. So thanks very much, Karen, for joining us again. It's been fantastic having your input, and we'll sincerely hope things turn a wee bit different for Australia in your absence.
Thanks for having me.
A 19-4, New Zealand leading this men's fours final. First
again, buddy.
Bowl coming down from Barry Lester.
Well played, Bass.
Hey.
Very good, mate.
Good leader, buddy.
family and friends watching this through Fox Sport Australia. We've got medal presentations at the end of this match for both this particular game and the final played this morning. That was the women's triple.
Sprint hard. Up. A little more, mate. Come on. Yeah, good.
Right, Maggie with his second ball getting into the area.
Come on, mate.
I just found, John, having a look outside as well, that there was definitely the more difficult side of the ring to play. I was surprised that Mike Nagy didn't change over at some stage. It has been real difficult, and I think we've evidenced it when we're going back in the other direction. If they have a slightly little bit more weight and a little bit wider, they won't come, but underneath the line, yeah, they just duck away. Just really would have liked to have seen Mike Nagy change over.
Right on, mate. Well played.
Mike Kernahan has been so successful down that side of the green.
And in this situation, does the skip just leave it to the player, basically? You're the lead, you know what you like, and let him go? Or at some stage, though, he's got to say, in a little conflab, why don't you change your hand? Or would you change your hand? But Nagy seems to be really convinced that the hand he's playing is the right one for him.
Yeah, particularly earlier on when he was struggling on it.
Of the track, mate.
However, he's stuck with it and has slightly improved.
All good, though. Don't mind that. Good touch, mate. Inside of the black one. In.
Australia holding the one shot. Brett Wilkie is connecting with the Nagy bowl. In the end, it's the green bowl of Australia that turns in for shot.
Hurry now. Come on, mate, get wheels.
Tortuous trip down there. Forsyth and Kernahan both urging that bowl on.
What's
another half a metre.
Trying to get a couple of turns
in a
out
good
of
position
that.
There, though.
Your chance. Give yourself a couple of feet. It's the front one.
Got to connect with something
now.
Here.
Brett Wilkie just a little bit unfortunate there, and it hasn't really gone Australia's way. They're getting the bowl, but not getting it full enough, and chance of turning back the New Zealand bowl there and making shots for Australia. However, just getting it on the edge, turns it around the corner, makes it harder to get to. However, Ali Forsyth will be keen for Blake Signal to get another one handy.
Love your track, mate.
Oh, you're that lovely track, mate.
Blakey. Stick on out. All good, love the way.
It is. Great to hear. Chance of holding up.
The back bowls there, one on the left is New Zealand, the one on the right, the green bowl, is Australia. Here comes Wilson now.
Hurry
now! To get inside that New Zealand bowl, it has, onto the jack. It does, and springs across to Australia. Very good bowl from Wilson.
Yes, it was from Aaron Wilson. Australia holding three.
Signal doesn't need to change a great deal on this.
Hurry, Blakey.
Oh, look at Forsyth crouching down. He's found that hole and almost took it clean.
two. It's the same bowl though, mate.
Yes, it was a pretty good effort from Blake Signal. It looked as though he had the jack clean.
Wilson quickly into his work again. Down that same track.
Come on.
He thinks it's the jack. No, it's not. It is. It is just and pushed it out their way, but it hasn't changed the situation. Still Australia holding a single, but not quite as safe looking as it was previously. They did have three, didn't they?
Yeah, I think the situation is that Australia at that point where they've got to try and make some shots are looking at turning back the New Zealand bowls. Unfortunately, connection with the jack, moving it out the side. They definitely held two. I just don't know with Blake Signal moving the jack slightly where it may have reduced the count by one. However, it's now Australia holding one with Ali Forsyth. Got a bit of room now.
Well, that shot bowl is quite isolated there too. There's 3 seconds of New Zealand's around it.
Yes, we can see the white. Blue disc bowl is Ali Forsyth. Looks to draw inside it and does so. Gee, he's playing well, Ali Forsyth, isn't he?
He's been playing very well. That's no inconsistencies from him.
Hanging wide.
Looking to maybe take the jack into the ditch or. That wouldn't have been an advantage, just onto the jack drawing it.
Yes, I think it's really just the draw, because any movement of the jack back, New Zealand have got a bowl past the jack.
Forsyth, another one in there.
Run, Mike.
They like this one too. I like this one very much. Stop it, stop it.
Yeah, Ali Forsyth.
So New Zealand holding a couple. The two blue shot bowls of Ali Forsyth.
Australia have really only just got the one bowl on the head.
So they have to be careful that they don't get rid of that.
Close to the jack, I think.
Oh, just whistling past. That was the option for them. And so New Zealand get another two. And really, they are now starting to dominate in this game. Well, not starting. They have been dominant, but always with a lot of ends to play. You can always imagine that Australia will fight their way back into it, but New Zealand are not allowing them to.
Certainly so. And Australia having scored only the one single shot since the 30, and so playing the 14th end, in the last 10, Australia have scored one. New Zealand have scored 19.
I've got quite a good crowd here today and tomorrow. I'm sure about that forecast now. It wasn't very promising, but I think it's changed quite dramatically. This wind might have blown a bit of the rubbish through, but two finals tomorrow, one featuring the women's pair. And that features New Zealand against Wales. And in the afternoon, it's the final event of World Bowls 2016, the men's singles, with New Zealand involved in that against Canada. So it's Ryan Bester of Canada against Shannon McElroy of New Zealand. So as you can see, you get a very good position here in the stands. There's lots of seating available. And here's Lester drawing shot. It's Australia desperately trying to get back into this game to farewell Mark Casey in the best possible way.
Pretty good again, buddy. Down to your own. Yeah, good stuff, Mike.
Two pretty handy bowls from Barry Lester.
One down, mate. You draw a shot there, you touch it, real good.
Kernahan playing the hand that he hasn't used much in this match. Also, that's good cover down there. Well, not cover, it's setting up the backest bowl.
Yes, and looking down, he turned around with a little bit of a wry smile, just thinking to himself, gee, it is a bit different down that hand, isn't it?
That's,
of weight.
Yeah, and that's right next to the tee. So if we only have one, have we had one respot on the whole game, I think? Yeah, early on. Kernahan. Looking to take weight. Off a bit of weight.
Yes, the weight there adjustment's important. So he is certainly better played. How much it'll go through there. He gave it a very good chance.
They're good placement, though, aren't they? Those two bowls, the second shot is New Zealand, and then those two around the 2 metre mark.
Yes, Ali Forsyth will be looking for another handy bowl.
Yep.
Stay high.
He's going to be dropping shots. He only wants to be dropping the one.
Well, well done, mate. Well done, buddy.
Drawing a shot, mate. Another handy one. How bowl's the ball pass? Drop hard, pal. Down a bit more. Down. Good.
A good turn of that one, mate. You might be wide to get that.
Mate's awesome.
Toucher.
So after this, there's four ends remaining. And it's becoming more and more difficult for Australia. They really do need to pick up shots on this end. And Wilson now looking to help this cause. Not with that.
Hold tight, mate. Love the way.
So I think Aaron Wilson was looking to sit through the closest New Zealand bowl. Probably had too much weight for it. It's really just over a draw, particularly going in this direction where we've recognised that the bowls pick up the speed at the end, going into the 2 metre area.
I don't even mind that weight, mate, if you try to land any of those black ones. What do you got?
Hold. He's got the hole.
Oh. I think he's got the edge of the bowl.
He has to, yeah. Well, he didn't work his way, though. Cleanly.
Australia holding definitely, well, definitely the two shots in front there, yep. At the top of the screen. Not sure whether the blue disc bowl on the left-hand side, as we look at it, the jack there is a third, but definitely two to Australia.
Yep.
Important for New Zealand, I think, to really try and look at getting another one handy here.
Well, look at down at the left-hand side there, all red bowls, all red disc bowls to New Zealand, but to get at the jack on that hand's pretty much impossible. So they don't need to, they're not looking at scoring big anyway, they just want to stop Australia scoring heavily now. Score or prevent Australia getting in amongst it.
Well, Forsyth looks as though he might be lining up to hit those two green bowls short of the jack, so he's on the drive definitely on his forehand, the left-hander's forehand. These two bowls he's heading for now.
Got them. Got them. What a shot. What a shot.
Oh, we're just running for you. It does, because the bowl went across to the side and took out the other Australian bowl as well. Here we see it. He's hit the two there, and it goes across and removes the other one and the back blue one. So New Zealand's got about three shots.
How fortunes can change.
There's the end result of it, and the three red disc bowls for New Zealand are all counting. So it's back to the draw and recovery for Casey.
Casey.
And that's that run shot of Forsyth. Anyone would be proud of that. It was in his mind to take them both if he could, but he had to hit that front ball in exactly the right position to get the ricochet. Taking out the second was great, and then and then the next one as well.
It's the confidence, isn't it?
Yeah.
And of course, he's
yeah.
had a couple of drives which he's been successful with, and he knows that he's pretty on song with them. Steps onto the mat, away he goes. Is he now on the draw? You see it here, movement of the jack. No, well, he just draws the shot cold. Great stuff, Ali Forsyth.
Now he's gone from a run shot to
Eddie,
a draw.
Eddie, how far's it going to go?
Without blemish.
It's only one, yeah?
One. Now, Casey doesn't want to shift the jack. Oh, and he's turned his back on it. It's well away. Look at this. This is. That's a pressure ball. Under pressure. The jack is picked up by Kernahan.
Yes, it's been
Aaron Hyde shows one for New Zealand.
Been a battle for Mark Casey, hasn't it? He's been put under all sorts of pressure by Ali Forsyth. At times when you'd think that he was going to be drawing to add, it's Ali Forsyth who comes in and changes the scene dramatically. So, Ali Forsyth, outstanding. As New Zealand continue the scoring mode. 18 shots difference, four ends to go.
Well, nobody would have predicted a margin like this for either team playing the 15th end of the final. But 22-4. Forsyth keeps that jacket on, and he must be sweltering under that.
I think he's just got into a mode that he doesn't realise it. He's just so engrossed
the last thing
in the
he's
game.
Thinking about is his jacket.
Yeah, he's just so wound within the game. You can see it. He's sort of giving you a little fist pump to himself when he's having a successful shot, and he's just wound right into the atmosphere of the game, and underneath he's stifling hot.
2 feet.
Mike Nagy, his wife Ants, and son Riker watching this. His mum in Palmerston North, Joyce in Palmerston North, glued to the TV set and probably wanting to go and make a cup of tea, but doesn't want to leave the set. Do that afterwards, probably be something stronger than a cup of tea. Here's a good bowl from Mike Nagy. Lester wanting to add a couple of metres onto that last bowl of his. Certainly take him more green.
Well played, Baz.
Just inside that New Zealand bowl. This time they do get some good fortune here. Australia holding one. Kernahan, who's been quite superb in the number two spot for New Zealand.
Run hard, buddy. All you got, Kearney.
Looking for an extra half metre.
Come on, one more. Yeah, hold on.
Might well have just meant the shots with New Zealand, that first bowl of Kernahan. He's just added that wee bit on. Even Casey is applauding this one as he sees what Kernaghan has done. Jack touches, moves it ever so slightly.
Yes, it's been a huge contribution to this game by Mike Kernaghan. He's been steady throughout. He changed his hand a couple of times where he was forced to, and was a little bit looser, but always in the area. But generally, overall, it's been Mike Kernaghan. It's been an amazing display.
Good shot here, too. Concise instructions. You can work out where Forsyth wants it. Just beating that left-hand bowl. That's what he wanted. Might just be cutting across that really centre line a bit early, though.
Hang around.
Well, mate.
Andy.
Touch him, mate.
Wilson looks to be in the area.
Look at this.
It's a great ball from Aaron Wilson. He's looking to make the Australian score a little bit more respectful.
What a draw, mate. Fall off this green line, you go close. Way's pretty good.
Australia holding probably three shots.
Signal. Forsyth's on as Haunch is looking at it. Oh, didn't quite hit. If it had hit that square, it might have been valuable, but didn't quite have the weight. Not what he was after. Players march down now following the last bowl by Aaron Wilson. The skips will have a look and a discussion. And Wilson's bowl comes in, not quite in the count, not quite in the count, but it ensures that Australia is holding three.
Yes, we can see all the three blue disc bowls there of Australia. It's a very good shot from Aaron Wilson, moving the jack. New Zealand have plenty of bowls in the area, so I'm sure Ali Forsyth will look at attack. He is.
We're on it.
Hey, Dave. The touch on the side.
So the jack has stayed inside. And when you see the red ball, well, we'll have a look at this again here. Ali Forsyth going through, and we can see the red ball getting peeled back, the New Zealand ball, and it sits right on the edge of the ditch. It's not a toucher, and New Zealand have got two shots. When it's running for you, it runs for you, and
yeah,
it's just a fantastic result there from Ali Forsyth.
This is a very good try, though. Second shot.
Who's third, huh?
Now, that's worth a couple, isn't it?
Yes,
they don't need to worry about it. They've got the shot.
Ali Forsyth will look at drawing another one.
Forsyth with his last bowl, and this is the 15th end. New Zealand have an advantage of 18 at the moment. They're holding an unbeatable shot at the moment, and not quite two.
Give it a barrel.
Well, Casey, looking to drive the New Zealand bowl.
Here it goes. Misses. Another single for New Zealand.
And Australia,
and I think they've conceded. What a sublime game by this New Zealand four. Mike Nagy, Mike Kernaghan, Blake Signal and Ali Forsyth have completely dominated Australia. They're good mates. 23 points to 4.
Yes, it was a pretty complete performance from New Zealand. Some outstanding play from Alec Forsyth. He skipped the team incredibly throughout that game, and they dominated right throughout. Mike Kernahan was so steady at two and the four. Chipped in there. There was some great balls played from Blake Signal when he had to, and also from Mike Nagy. But it was New Zealand who dominated throughout. 23-4, they won the final. Congratulations, New Zealand. Gold medal to the New Zealand four.
11 of the last 12 ends New Zealand scored, and that one that they didn't score on, they conceded just a single. So from being 3-2 down after three ends, they really took control and ended up winning after 15 ends by 23-4. Quite outstanding. One of the best fours performances we've seen from New Zealand for quite some time. And what it has done, it has earned Ali Forsyth and his team the gold medal. They're the world fours champions.
Ali Forsyth, there's moments in your illustrious career, along with these gentlemen and the battles that you've had with Australia, where you will look back, and this will definitely be one of those ones. You are the world champions, but more importantly, that performance was sensational.
Yeah, thank you very much. Look, very pleasing to finish off a huge week. You know, look, we put in so many good performances to get to this point. It would have been such a shame not to be able to finish it off. And a few nervy moments to start off, but the guys really played awesome and made my job so much easier.
Yeah, as a skip, your drive game and also your calls for them when you were getting down and wanting those changes from the gentlemen in your team, the way that they upped their game and responded so well and get that big run through the middle there where pretty much Australia were kept only 2 or 1 points throughout, you must have been really happy.
Oh, over the moon, you know, look, to keep such a high-quality side like that to, you know, such a small amount of points is unbelievable. That's things you only really dream about, and, yeah, can't really believe it's happened, to be fair.
And in front of friends and family here in your hometown, adds to it as well?
Oh, absolutely. Look, the support we've had has been awesome, you know, not just here today, but all through the week, and it's much appreciated and makes it even more special.
And I've got one last question. How did you wear the jacket the whole time? Were you boiling, mate?
Yeah, it was warm, but a bit of superstition. The only time I took it off during the week, I started to play rubbish, so I thought I'm keeping it on today.
Ali, mate, congratulations. You are the world champs. Well done.
Awesome. Thank you.
Mark, mate, I know this must be a tough one, but more so came up against the New Zealand side. You always knew it was going to be a battle out there. They were just on top of their game.
Absolutely. All four played fantastically well, and Ali obviously converted well, as he normally does. So much too good today, and definitely does hurt, yeah.
1 versus 2 pretty much throughout the entire world and making it through to the final. You're here with a run, but more importantly, on behalf of the bowls world and all the community, your supporters, your friends and family, last time you'd be out here representing Australia, we want to say thank you. And looking back on your career, you must be really happy.
Yeah, obviously proud to wear the Australian colours for so long, and something I'll probably miss. It'll probably sink in tonight. So, yeah, thank you to everyone for coming out, and, yeah, very enjoyable.
Thanks for the memories, mate. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, it was Ali Forsyth on the drive. He started well and he continued well right throughout this game, with New Zealand picking up a couple of shots on the first end. But Australia was not to be outdone. Mark Casey in his final game for Australia, trailing the jack in the ditch, but I think it was a never-ending support and fantastic bowls from Mike Kernahan that laid a solid foundation for New Zealand when they picked up a four on the fourth end. They were all drawn. However, Blake Signal, he came to the four, and it was him who drew the single shot there. New Zealand continued on their charge to the final here in this final, picking up another couple of shots going forward. The results were always going their way. When they played the weighted shots, they got the fantastic result. And Ali Forsyth was solid throughout as he draws once again to continue the lead. Picking up a two there for New Zealand, they scored on the final 11 ends of this match, allowing Australia only pick up the single and the two. Ali Forsyth, the class continues, the players are happy. New Zealand continuing on their way, and it was Ali Forsyth in New Zealand who picked up another shot. And gold medal it is to New Zealand.
So there we have it. Yes, a great one there by New Zealand. And Mark Casey saying goodbye to his friends and family who have come to support him as he ends an illustrious career. We're going to take a break here in Christchurch. And don't go anywhere. When we come back, the medal ceremonies for the team's events.